Hello, I'm Daniel Trifonov. I'm very happy to announce that a project of the last several years have been completed, and I invite you now on a journey with Rachmaninoff.
Rachmaninoff never really stopped searching for new ideas, and every his concerto brought new view on the genre that he was master of.
The construction of his music is what always interested me the most. The harmonies are what makes my heart melt when I listen to Rachmaninoff, and definitely when I conduct.
Of course, the concerti are one of his most personal works that share both the intimacy in his music as well as its brilliance. The wide scope of its structure and its melodies perhaps reflects the wide-ranging soul of him as a musician. In general, he was very curious and flexible person.
Is there any concerto more famous than the second concerto? I think it's just the absolute standard bearer of what a concerto is and should be.
Structurally, actually, it's one of the most simplest concerti of Rachmaninoff. It's almost bare bones in a structure and in a good way. And that leads to one big dilemma. Rachmaninoff is, we perceive it as a very romantic composer, but with the simplicity found in many of his work, but especially in this concerto, it becomes very tricky to manage time and rhythm. One of most important novelties in his works is that even though he is very romantic composer in his melodies and his harmonies, he influenced a lot rhythm in the 20th century, and for example Prokofiev was actually in many ways influenced by the rhythmical stability of Rachmaninoff music and how much rhythmical pulse meant, both in a faster tempo and in something like a second movement. Rhythm as a defining cage for the bird in it, that is melody.
The fourth concerto, I think it's still a concerto that would gain to be played more often. I'm conducting it more and more, and I hope that by having a new complete recording of these concertos, it might help that concerto getting even more in the repertoire.
Well, fourth concerto is my personal favorite. It's the most original of them all, I think. I find it's the one where Rachmaninoff really tried to go out of his comfort zone. He explored a variety of different styles. Language-wise, to me, it's very novel. The way a concerto begins, actually, to me, it feels like a train travel. It starts with this very determined momentum. Music as emotion. One of the great examples of treating music as the art that exists in time, but also in space. It's an incredible journey in this concerto of always going towards certain destination. And just the opening of this concerto is one of the great examples of it. Rachmaninoff wrote some brilliant piano transcriptions, and one of them transcription of Bach violin partita.
Second and fourth were very unique. They're not like anything else Rachmaninoff wrote. The second one actually has a lot of polyphony as well. So I thought of pairing them with transcriptions of Bach partita by Rachmaninoff, which is brilliant. Of course, it was a great honor to record this concerto with orchestra that recorded the same concerto with Rachmaninoff. From the first note, I realized it's how how much respect we have for this music and how much knowledge we have just for the, how to understand the idiom of Rachmaninoff. And to me it was a great idea to record the all remaining concerti.
There is something in the air. It's difficult to explain, but Philadelphia musicians, it's a mixture of tradition, pride, understanding, and value. Of course, when we say Philadelphia sound, it's all about the generosity of the sound, and that matches really well the generosity of spirit of Rachmaninoff's music. Daniil knows how this music breathes. It feels like he is composing it while he's playing it. The first time I heard him, I just thought, this man is already saying more than most pianists of any era. And yet, something tells me that he has even more to say. I think this is just something that is beyond human comprehension, definitely beyond mine and beyond all of us